good way of keeping track of your to-dos. I have long ago given up on the Outlook task because they're just too cluttered and they don't synchronize really well across devices, and the interface isn't very nice to work with. Microsoft recently launched a new application called To-Do that you can use across different devices. It's a very simple app, but it's easy to work with, and it really helps to keep track of what your to-dos. Let me give you a quick overview.
When you open the To-Do app, the first thing you see is My Day. This view is intended to help you focus on the to-dos today. Tap the menu icon to see all your other to-dos. To-dos are organized into lists, and when you first start using the app, you already have a list called To-Do. Tap Add a To-Do to add something to your to-do list. Here I'll add Call Car Service. A good rule of thumb is to add single item tasks that you don't have scheduled in your calendar. When you're done, click Done and the task is added. Really fast and simple. If you want to add more information to this task, tap it. Here you can add multiple steps or subtasks if you will. Add the task to My Day. Set a reminder or a due date. Setting the due date to today doesn't automatically add the task to My Day. You need to decide yourself what should be on your My Day. I should get the car service soon, but it's not super urgent, so I'll add a due date by next week. To add multiple lists, tap the menu icon and then New List. A best practice for task management is to organize tasks into various categories so that you don't have to clutter your brain with too many tasks at once. Here I'll add a list that I call Home. By having them separated, I don't have to worry about seeing them when I'm working. Here I'll add a to-do to fix the toilet seat that's been broken for a while. You can easily create to-do lists and get everything out of your brain and into the app. Now I have a list of things I need to pack for my upcoming business trip and a list of things I need to do when I'm in Sweden. Now let's have a look at My Day. If you're really organized, you open the app the first thing in the morning and you plan your to-dos for the day. No matter if you have to-dos from the previous day that you haven't completed, you always start each new day fresh with a clean page, which is really motivational. Unlike other task management apps where you're typically faced with all the things you haven't done, My Day actually helps you start fresh every day. From here, you can add a to-do directly to your day. Here I'll add that I need to email John. Another way to plan your to-dos is to select them from your various to-do lists. Here the app helps you. Tap the light bulb and you'll get suggestions for what to add. Naturally, to-dos that have due dates set for today will be recommended for you. Here you can easily add to-dos to your My Day by just tapping the plus icon next to the app. I'll go through the suggestions and select the ones that I'll do today. When you've completed a task, just tap the little circle to mark it as complete. Now, the to-do isn't deleted, it just shows as complete, which I like because it really gives a great feeling of accomplishment. To delete a to-do altogether, just swipe it to the left and then confirm that you want to delete it. To remove something from your My Day, but still keep it in your to-do list, swipe to the right. You can always go into a specific list and add a to-do to your My Day by just swiping to the right. Your to-dos are now accessible from all the places where you've logged into the To-Do app with the same account.
So as you can see, it's a very simple and easy to use app and it does the work. It also integrates with Outlook, so if you want to see your tasks there as well, they turn up there from the To-Do app. What I'm still missing is the ability to share your list and your to-dos. It would be wonderful if I could share some of my to-dos with my husband, for instance. But I'm sure that this is coming and you can keep track of these on the user voice of the frequently asked requests for the to-do app. If you want to learn more, you can read the blog post on businessproductivity.com. Thanks for watching.